Good evening. Tonight in Prime Network News, the freedom of entry to the Shire arrive in entry to the over to the Channel 7 studios in Melbourne for the national and international news at 6 o'clock.
Good evening. Heading our news tonight, police, angry at a directive they say will force them to be
on Dallas.
Have a nice time.
You could be looking forward to having a nice time, too, if that cowboy of yours is stuck around.
Clayton, if it's cash you need, go to Ellie for it.
I don't want Ellie to know about it.
I'll be damned if I'll let you push me out of your life when I know that we can work this thing out together.
We have nothing to work out.
You might be the only woman that JR loves, but you're certainly not the only woman that JR makes love with.
I find you fascinating.
Why? Because I have a body and a brain?
Because you have a beautiful body.
Be watching Dallas 8th at noon. See the midday show with Ray Martin, an informative chat show featuring lots of fun and popular local and international celebrities.
The 6th Bright Autumn Festival is proudly sponsored by the Prime Network RVN-AMV. Bright is beautiful at any time of the year, but at autumn festival time, it offers so much more to the visitor. Whether it's gold panning or tours of the apple orchards, tobacco and raspberry farms, or the chestnut groves, Bright is an autumn delight. The Bright Autumn Festival is sponsored by your station, the Prime Network, RVN-AMV, and is guaranteed to entertain and delight.
Here are the Weather Bureau district forecasts issued at 3 o'clock this afternoon and presented by CIG, specialists in gas, welding, spray equipment and industrial safety equipment. The Riverina, dry, cool and partly cloudy. Target temperatures for tomorrow, compliments of Holloway's Building Supplies, Albury-Wodonga 13, Wagga 13, Griffith 14 and Deniliquin 14.
Before we commit ourselves on this loan, I'd like your husband to come in and discuss it with us.
I am on my own now. But as you know, I have quite a good income.
Well, there may be problems. Funds are tight.
It is unlawful under the Anti-Discrimination Act to discriminate against anyone on the grounds of their race, sex, or marital status. This law was introduced to promote equality of opportunity for all people. For more information, phone 231 1655.
Good evening, Ashley Walsh with Channel 4 Regional News. Heading tonight's...
This is 7 National News with Ross Simons.
All the opportunities offered by this great country of ours in the great years now within our grasp.
An emotional Prime Minister calls on Australians to back Labor's policies. Also, the space shuttle crew makes history. And a grieving mother appeals to her daughter's killer. Good evening. More money for the aged, a new job creation scheme, and a pledge to try to keep inflation under 5%. These were the major planks in Bob Hawke's election policy today. The Prime Minister also pitches his policy at the young, promising an additional 20,000 places for childcare. No increases in the Medicare levy over the next 3 years and more tax cuts. Two of Australia's best-known bookmakers, plus a Catholic priest, have been publicly accused of having prior knowledge of the fine cotton ring-in last month. Bill Waterhouse and his son Robbie and Father Edward O'Dwyer were named in Sydney today at the AJC's hearing of show cause notices against the men.
A total of 9 people face being banned from racecourses and or losing their licence to operate following the stewards' inquiry. Those inquiries were held in private, and today, for the first time, details of the elusive Father Edward O'Dwyer's involvement were revealed. The stewards say he falsely told them that he did not meet with Nigel Clark, the brother of named punter Gary Clark, that he did not know the name of the tipster which prompted his $1,000 bet on fine cotton, that he did not go specifically to the Appin Dog meeting to place the bets, and that he had falsely claimed to be in England on August 18. Interstate bookmaker Bill Waterhouse and his son Robbie, also a bookmaker, have an extra clause in their show cause notices. As well as alleged prior knowledge of the ring-in, it's alleged they connived with others in placing bets. The 3 lawyers representing Father O'Dwyer and Bill and Robbie Waterhouse objected strongly to the steward's report containing the allegations being tabled as evidence. Their objections were overruled, but under the AJC's fair play rules, each of the eight barristers can now cross-examine all witnesses called to the hearing. As a result, it took most of the day for the Queensland vet, Dr. Mason, to give his evidence on identifying the substitute bold personality after the race, plus evidence from four interstate bookies who had fielded at Warwick Farm. The hearing resumes tomorrow. Kay Brown for 7 National.
This Saturday and Sunday, RVN-AMV present a live telecast of the final 2 days' play in one of the four major Grand Slam tennis events in the world, the Australian Tennis Open. Direct from Kooyong, the challengers and the champions will confront each other for the richest prize money in the history of Australian tennis. With Ivan Lendl defeated, the men's title will be wide open, while Martina Navratilova will fight hard to defend her crown. Don't miss all the championship action of the Australian Tennis Open, beginning at 1 p.m. this weekend.
A monkey of yourself. Climb into the ring with the 600-pound bear. Discover what it takes to train mortal enemies to work together. And get close to the world's smallest performers, human fleas. Join a tug of war for a dragon in Belgium. See one of the most dangerous ceremonies of New Guinea. And jump into a ritual mud-throwing contest in Japan.
Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Good evening. Tonight, a number of Victorian tax cuts to take effect.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Sydney Cricket Ground for this clash between the West Indian champions and the Australians trying desperately to take a match off them. The score at the moment is West Indies 4 and Australia 1 in this Benson Hedges World Series Cup. The Australian team today...
Good. Go on, roll over, lad.
Right, we're going to bet.
Good evening. Bushfires dominate our news tonight, with fires presently burning out of control near Wandillagong, at Beechworth and in the Dora Dora State Forest near Telmelmo. A bushfire that started at Mount Buffalo overnight is now burning out of control west of Wandillagong. The fire is burning along Demon's Ridge and spotting down into the Wandillagong Valley. Firemen are presently keeping a close watch on the township of...
Firefighters are being hampered by hot and windy conditions in the area. The fire started overnight with a number of lightning strikes in the Mount Buffalo National Park. Police evacuated a number of people from the mountain and closed the Mount Buffalo Road. Several hundred men are presently fighting the fire in the Wandillagong area. Country Fire Authority tankers from a wide area have been brought in to assist forestry tankers in the battle. The fire is presently burning on a 5 kilometre front and has already destroyed 15,000 hectares. Buckland Valley farmer Rory Lumsden lost his hay shed in the fire overnight as fires spotted across his property. Safety Council helicopters have also been used during the day, dumping water on the fire. Fixed-wing aircraft have also been utilised to dump fire retardant on the outbreak. Officials say the main blaze is causing a number of spot fires, with much of the fire burning in inaccessible country.
The Mount Buffalo fire is not the only one in the region causing concern to...
A large area of grassland was destroyed by fire overnight at Mountain Creek, southwest of Holbrook. An old farmhouse, which was being used to store a quantity of furniture, was destroyed in the fire. Some reports of stock losses from the fire have also been received. Firemen are still battling a blaze in the Dora Dora State Forest, Telmelmo area. The fire is out of control on several fronts. Volunteer firefighters and state emergency service personnel from Albury have also been called in to fight the outbreak. A number of small roads have been closed in the area. A fire just past Talangata is reported to be contained. However, firemen are still battling a blaze which started in the Woolshed Valley area near Beechworth. Police at Beechworth say the fire has already jumped the Chiltern to Beechworth and Wodonga to Beechworth roads. Police say both roads have been closed to all traffic. Police have also closed the Cabramatta Road from Cancoban to Kyandra and the Alpine Way from Cancoban to Threadbow due to the danger of fires in that area at the moment. Firemen late this afternoon were also called to a fire at Manella, which was reported to be burning well. Thick smoke from the fires in northeast Victoria and southern New South Wales covered the region throughout the day. Firemen will be working throughout the night in a bid to contain the still out of control fire.
Conduct a study aimed at improving public transport in the non-metropolitan areas of Victoria. Transport Minister Steve Crabb says the program will be implemented during the next 12 months. The study is designed to identify ways of improving passenger services in different areas of Victoria.
V-Line is now responsible for all passenger services in the non-metropolitan area of Victoria. Transport Minister Steve Crabb says consequently there is now the chance to develop integrated and coordinated public transport systems. He says the study program will begin with a detailed study of all public transport services in the Goulburn Valley area. The study area will include the shires of Cobram, Tungamar, Pilottown, Euroa and the cities of Shepparton and Echuca. Mr. Crabb says studies will be conducted in the different regions during this year, with the Northeast study scheduled to commence in November. He says the study will help the government provide the most effective and efficient public transport network throughout Victoria. Mr. Crabb says each study will take around 3 months and will be undertaken by a study team of V-Line officers. He says the officers will examine the total operation of public transport in each area. Each study will be advertised widely and written submissions will be sought from interested people and organisations.
And confusing off-road driving laws. Each and attempts to teach me how to hang 10 with mixed results. That's all next week on Good Morning Australia.
Call those who participated in our program survey. It's still not too late to tell us what you'd like to see in 1986. Additional survey forms can be obtained from the studios of AMV 4 Albury and RVN 2 Wagga, or from our offices in Young and Wangaratta. Forms are also available from your nearest Shell service station. Time is running out, so send your forms now and watch all the top shows in 86 on RVN AMV.
To Spellbinding Tales, the best in family entertainment Sunday at 6:30 with the wonderful World of Disney.
With Gordon Elliott and Kerri-Ann Kennelly, weekday mornings at 7 on Good Morning Australia.
Good evening. Among tonight's main stories, the Victorian Planning Appeals Board to conduct an inquiry in Wodonga conducted by the New South Wales Department of Sport and Recreation. Learn to swim programs are being held at swimming pools throughout the Riverina region during January. The first series runs until next Monday, with enrolments now being taken for the second series, which starts on the 14th of January.
The vacation swimming scheme caters mainly for primary school age students, with 243 enrolled at the North Albury swimming pool. Each series is conducted over 10 days with a 40-minute session each day. Those attending the clinics are divided into small groups, each with a qualified off-swim instructor employed by the Department of Sport and Recreation.
I cater for three different levels of swimming. The very beginners that have never had lessons before, they're developing water confidence and very basic learn to kick with kickboards and perhaps progressing on to basic swimming techniques. The next level of swimming are children who've had lessons before, can master the art of some swimming but can't swim 20 metres. They're into stamina building, stroke correction and some survival skills. The last group is a group that can swim at least 20 metres, preferably most of the pool. They're into stamina building, more stroke correction and more survival skills.
And what do the students obtain at the end of the course? Is there some sort of certificate?
Yes, at the end of the course, students will qualify for a Royal Life Saving Award. These come in six different levels. They build up from water awareness, water discovery, right up to junior swim and survive.
A young Holbrook athlete has been awarded a $250 grant to assist with travelling expenses for training in Sydney. Member for Albury Harold Mayer says the grant to Anthony Phyllis is part of a scheme to assist athletes living more...
RVN-AMV now present weather details for the Riverina MIA, Southwest Slopes and Northeast Victoria climatic regions as supplied by the Bureau of Meteorology.
And now the forecasts. Firstly, the Riverina MIA. Cool with southwest to southerly winds, a few showers and sunny periods, heading for a top of 24 degrees. For the Southwest Slopes, cool with southwesterly to southerly winds, a few showers but sunny periods and heading for a top of 23 degrees. For northeastern Victoria, fine apart from isolated showers about the ranges, cool and cloudy, heading for 22 degrees. And finally, the city's forecasts for Albury-Wodonga becoming fine and 22 degrees, and for Wagga Wagga, dry conditions are forecast with a maximum of 23 degrees.
That's all we have for you tonight on RVN AMV, but please join us again tomorrow night at 7 o'clock for Sale of the Century with Tony and Delveen. At 7.30 it's more adventure with Tales of the Gold Monkey. At 8.30 it's comedy with Carry On Laughing. At 9 o'clock it's family fun with Too Close for Comfort. And at 9.30 the conclusion to your big novels presentation, Sarah Dane. At 11.30 your news replay. Just before we go, we'd like to remind you that following the national anthem, RVN AMV will present a small sample of information available on 7Text. On behalf of us all here at RVN AMV, this is David Foster, wishing you a very peaceful night. ¶¶